guys, welcome back to my channel Fern with Sunanshu. This is me, Sonam, here. And before starting this vlog, I am just adding a small video here to share how I actually planned this trip. So guys, basically ye hamari second anniversary hai, so hum logon ne socha let's plan a trip here. So it's a second anniversary trip. So hum logon ne jo hamara jo plan hai, like 5 days hum log Muscat mein hai, and then next 10 days ke liye hum log Dubai mein honge. So let's फर्स्ट टॉक अबाउट द वीज़ा पार्ट. मैंने जब अपना वीज़ा कराया, मैंने ट्रैवल एजेंट के थ्रू कराया था. सो इट्स अ स्मूथ प्रोसेस. आपके पूरे डॉक्यूमेंटेशन और पूरा प्रॉपर होना चाहिए, एंड विद इन अ वीक और 10 डेज आपका वीज़ा आ जाता है. सो आप लोग एम्बेसी के थ्रू भी करा सकते हैं, या मुसाफिर.com जैसे बहुत सारे वेबसाइट्स हैं, आप उनके थ्रू भी अपना दुबई या मस्कट का वीज़ा आप करा सकते हो. या फिर आपके पास USA का वैलिड वीज़ा है तो वीज़ा ऑन अराइवल इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल. मैंने जो ये पूरा सर्किट बुक किया, ये ओमान एयरवेज से हम लोगों ने बुक किया है, और जो वेबसाइट मैंने यूज़ करी थी, आई हैव यूज स्काई स्कैनर. सुपर फ्रेंडली, सॉरी कस्टमर फ्रेंडली वेबसाइट, सॉरी. सो बहुत ईजी वेबसाइट है, एंड मैंने अपने टिकट्स आई थिंक 2-3 महीने पहले बुक कर लिए थे, बिकॉज आपको चीप टिकट्स मिल रहे हैं तो बुरा क्या है उसमें. या सो टिकट्स की बात हो गई, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस होटल बुकिंग पार्ट. या सो आई हैव डन माई होटल बुकिंग फ्रॉम booking.com, एंड आप Airbnb को भी ट्राई कर सकते हैं. स्टूडियो अपार्टमेंट स्टाइल है, वो भी बहुत बढ़िया एक ऑप्शन होता है. थाईलैंड वाले ट्रिप में मैंने Airbnb को यूज़ किया था, सो बहुत अच्छा ऑप्शन है वो भी. सो गाइज, नाउ लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड दिस होल मस्कट एंड दुबई व्लॉग.
Hey guys, so this is Sonam here. Ranshuma right there sitting, driving next to me. So हम लोग मेरे डैड के ऑफिस जा रहे हैं, एंड देन माय डैड विल ड्रॉप अस ऑन एयरपोर्ट, एंड वी हैव अ फ्लाइट अराउंड 7:30, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू मस्कट. बेस्ट पार्ट जो हमारे साथ होने वाला है, कि हम लोग जब दुबई में होंगे उस टाइम पे दुबई शॉपिंग फेस्टिवल होगा.
So guys, we are on the way to airport, and we are traveling by Oman Airways. Here we are done with all the airport formalities, and the total distance from Delhi to Muscat is around 3 hours 35 minutes. Now we are going inside the aircraft. I'm super excited, like super pumped up. So it's time to take off. So I will see you guys from Muscat. Bye bye.
We are saying hi from Muscat, and we have just landed, and it's 24 degrees. बहुत pleasant weather होने वाला है, obviously. दिल्ली की सर्दी वाले दिन इस करेंगे. I'll see you guys soon.
So guys, Ragini is coming to pick us from airport, and guys, a quick tip I am telling you, Muscat is on the traditional side, so it's a rule, you are not allowed to wear western outfit and the revealing outfit inside the city.
So we are about to check in our hotel, and this is our hotel.
That's our room. Ragini, say hi.
And look at the city from our balcony. Wow.
So that's the bathroom area. A decent size. And a small kitchen here.
Good morning guys, so it's a sweet good morning from Muscat, because we are in Muscat. Let me show you the view from our hotel balcony. Come.
So that's the morning view from our hotel balcony. It's super sunny there, and it's already 8 o'clock, so we are about to start this beautiful day.
Going to Jabal Sham and Aluta Caves, and it's a 3.5 hour drive. मैं हमेशा drive और ride में क्यों confused होती हूँ? So 3 घंटे का हमारा drive है, and Anshuman cousin is coming to pick us. So we are all set to explore Muscat. अब हम मस्कत वाले हो गए हैं. Now I'll get ready. वैसे तो मैं हो ही गई हूँ ready. बस थोड़ा सा कुछ 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 करना है. And then I'll see you guys soon. Bye bye.
So that's my stuff I'm carrying.
So guys, we are out to explore this beautiful city and we have decided first we'll explore the outskirts of the city and our agenda for today is Pala Fort, Aluta Cave and Jabal Sham. Yeah, so guys, here you can see the date plantation is going on. It's very common here in Oman. Yeah, the highways and the roads are fantastic here, super smooth, but keep a check over your speed, guys.
So I am vlogging again and right now it's 10:30 and 19 degrees. Nice, so we stopped by a cafe shop to have some coffee and tea.
So here I'm enjoying my small cup of tea and the distance from city to fort is around 189 kilometers and approximately 2 hours it will take.
So guys, done with the parking right there. So we are going to explore this Pala Fort. So guys, this is Pala Fort and this is one of the oldest and the biggest fort in Oman. Hi guys, what's up? So reached this Pala Fort and Anjuman is collecting the tickets. So let me tell you some quick facts about this fort. This is one of the oldest forts in Oman and it's the only fort here that comes under World Heritage site. Interesting, right? So basically it's a small fort.
So guys, here we are done with our tickets and the ticket charges are 500 bejas for each and timing to visit this fort is 9 to 4. So here we are entering into the fort. Yeah, so guys, this whole fort is divided into three parts. Yeah, and guys, this fort is underwent the massive restoration work and then reopened in 2012. Guys, the credit goes to tribe Banu Nahiban. And the whole construction is completed between 12th to 15th century. So guys, now we are heading towards our second destination, that is Aluta Cave, and the distance from fort to Aluta Cave is around 20 to 25 minutes, not so far. So guys, now we are in the parking of Aluta Cave and going to park a car. So guys, only 750 people are allowed in a single day to visit Aluta Cave and I have paid 7 Omani Riyal for 2 persons. So now we are inside the train and about to start this small ride. Yeah, so guys, it's an electric train and this train will carry you towards the entrance of the cave. And I am on the mountain side, so definitely I am gonna enjoy the view. So guys, the humidity inside the cave will be 70 to 75%. Yeah, so now we are about to reach at the cave entrance. So these caves are 3.5 million years old and they have created an artificial opening for tourists in 2006. And here you can also find some blind fishes and some bats also. So guys, the total length of the cave is 5 kilometers, but only 850 meters is accessible to the general public. So guys, here I am ending this Aluta Cave tour and just going to have some lunch and enjoying this seesaw ride with Ragini. So now we are heading towards our next stop after Aluta Cave, that is Jabal Sham. The road is fairly straightforward and easy, but at the end you are approaching to the top of the Jabal Sham. The road becomes a dirt track, but it's a different kind of experience. So I have enjoyed this dirt track drive. So finally we have reached the final destination, that is Jabal Sham, the highest point in the Gulf. And Jebel Shamit is literally the mountain of the sun because of its canyon. It's very obvious. Yeah, it's the canyon right in front of me. It's so huge, like huge. I can't even describe in my words. The Jebel Sham is a very famous tourist spot in Muscat, and from Muscat city to Jebel Sham, the total distance is around 240 kilometers only. So guys, this Jebel Sham is the second highest mountain after Jebel Akhdar. Jebel Akhdar is a green mountain, and this Jebel Sham comes under the range of Al Azhar, if I'm pronouncing right, I don't know. So the temperature is 17 to 18 degrees right now, and the view is spectacular here. Like, I am actually loving it. So guys, here I am ending this vlog. I hope you'll enjoy this video. Do let me know by your comments, and do subscribe to my channel and share this video. I'll see you guys soon. Bye bye.